you off another episode of On the Paint Table. It's my weekly show about what I got done, what's new, what's been worked on, and look at stuff that's coming up. So today, we're going to take a look at some Rumble Slam minis, as well as a couple more characters, models for Relic Blade, which is something I've just filmed two more games with Owen for to try and finish off our Seekers and Sanctuaries campaign. So if you haven't seen Rumble Slam before, it's basically a fantasy wrestling game, sort of like Blood Bowl, but for wrestling fans. It has all kinds of superstars and also generic characters, and you play a match for Dosh in some kind of fantasy casino. Try to check each other in the ring. It's pretty cool. I got the star set. I got it all painted up this week, and I'll show you some stuff coming up too. Actually, I don't know if I have a lot to show you coming up because most of it's actually at home being worked on, but we'll show you what I've done, and then I'll show you a couple things that are coming up. So here are my two teams for Rumble Slam. We've got teams over here. This is, what did I call them? I called them the Fantastic Phoenixes or something like that. Not the Fabulous Freebirds. We have an Ogre Grappler and a Halfling Grappler and a Halfling Brawler. An Ogre in the back there, Abel. And then two Wrestlers. You got Precipice there on the right because he kind of looks like Edge. And I can't remember what I named the bald guy. Probably Nathan Jones because he's kind of Nathan Jones. And what's cool is they're all based on clear acrylic bases, so you can kind of see the ring. TG Combat makes this. They make tons of MDF terrain. They make a big MDF ring for this game as well. But it comes with a really nice neoprene, fully printed, like, beautiful mat that you'll see in the Let's Play. So you can see everything through it, basically, when you're on these bases. I affixed them just by putting some etching onto the actual acrylic base. So I just roughed it up a little bit with the X-Acto knife. And then I glued it down with Mod Podge, which is a great adhesive. You can get a transparent, clear, glossy acrylic one, which is what I use in this case. You can't really tell where the glue is, and it means you won't frost the base with super glue and stuff like that. And over here, we have Team Oracle, not Team Angle. We've got it's two goblins. There's a goblin brawler and a goblin grappler, an orc brawler, an orc grappler, and a troll in the back here. Painted up again this week and affixed some bases the same way as I did my human team. So I'm really excited about this. It looks like silly, goofy fun. If you were ever a kid that watched Saturday Morning Wrestling in the 80s, or, you know, I guess Raw and SmackDown and WCW and ECW and all those great things in the 90s and early 2000s, then this is the game for you. It's got homages, tons of great wrestlers. It's clearly been done with a lot of love, and the models are hilarious, if nothing else. It's a nice light Blood Bowl for wrestling fans. And then over here, we painted up my Thiefly. This is my Thief with her Smoke Bomb and Dagger for Relic Blade. It's another Sean's minis. And her cat over here. So I did this one as a white tiger. The last one was kind of like a dun, like a mountain lion. I wanted to be different, but these are another companion model. I can hang out with a hero. So I wanted to have another speedy, zippy kitty cat to throw some binds down. And this is for our Seeker and Sanctuary campaign. We have a thief to go with my other Iron Sworn. Takes me up to 12 models this week, which wasn't too bad. And I'll show you what I'm working on next week. I got some Dark Age throwdowns coming up, and I'm painting up a new army. Well, I guess a new saint to go with my generic Forsaken that I painted up for Immortals this year. So I'm going to add Saint Isaac. And I've got the starter set as well, but I'm going to do some... I like flamethrowers. I like Saint Isaac. So we're going to start with a double Centipede, double Prometheus, Isaac Controller, Korra, 7-model list to get ourselves going. And it'll probably have an Ajax suit in it eventually too when the new card comes out for the Ajax suits. So I can swap somebody in and out and just like a militiaman for like an odd body. Because I already have those painted. I'm pretty stoked about them. I'm mounting them on the cool base inserts from Warsenal. So these are the techie base inserts. Although I didn't realize how deep these were when I did them. I'm going to double layer this one because this is sunk way too. I had to put something underneath it probably to push them out a little bit. And at the same time, I got to get done this cart. This is the Dark Age salvage cart. There's actually an objective in the new Martian Immortality 2017 rules for Dark Age. And then I'm going to do six objective markers that are actually 3D. So these holding tanks, I got that idea from Dave Taylor. And these awesome gibbets and cages that are also here. They're like big like holding pens for slaves. I'm going to paint them up as well. And that gives me lots of objective markers to have swinging around for the objectives that you need for MTI. So that's my upcomingness. I'm working on this basically for the next 2 weeks, and I'm pretty stoked about it because the models are super nice. I might take it with me tomorrow actually to get it all finished and built. So again, another On the Paint Table, what I got done this week. 12 models wasn't too bad. I'm kind of back in the saddle for painting right now, and I'm pretty jazzed for my new stuff for Dark Age.
I'm not planning on doing any new 40k stuff for the time being. I'm probably just going to try out my old armies and the new 40k rules, grab the new rulebooks and stuff. Although I may paint some Primaris Space Marines in the near future because they do look pretty rad. So we'll see you for more on the paint table next week. Until next time, I'm Ash.